Calvin J. Kendall. I was walking by Mr. Carterman's store and I kind of peeked in through the window and here's this clown holding a gun on him.
Yeah, he was waving it in my face, demanding money.
I wasn't demanding. I was just joking around.
You threatened to blow my head off.
I meant that figuratively, not literally.
What's that supposed to mean?
I don't think I have to answer that.
No words, you're welcome. Yo, Levitt?
Sir?
Mr. Carterman, Officer Levitt will take a statement.
Can't you just use the one I gave you last time?
I'm afraid not.
Ah, who cares? It'll be kind of fun this time. I get to put somebody away. Nothing personal, you understand.
Now, go ahead and enjoy yourself.
Sir, have a seat. Oh, yeah. I hope you'll forgive the way I'm dressed.
Yeah, forget it.
Thank you.
Mr. Kendall. Possible we've met before.
Who, me? Not unless you spent some time up around Billings, Montana.
Billings, Montana? No, never been there.
Don't feel bad. It's kind of like Cleveland with sheep.
Well, Joe, let's run a check on Mr. Kendall here, huh?
Sure, Barney. On your feet, Kendall. Come on.
Sit. Fourth precinct, would you hold? Yeah, Kobe. Harrison Dietrich was shot at? Are they all right? Okay, they were checking out a disturbance. Who cares? Are they all right? They are. Well, why didn't you say so in the first place? Well, think a minute, Kogan. That should have been the first words out of your mouth.
What's going on?
Harrison Dietrich was shot at.
Are they all right?
Yeah, they were checking out this disturbance.
Whoa, Joe!
Yeah, they're fine.
Thank you.
Kogan? Kogan will fill you in on details as soon as he finishes laughing.
Here, Harpo.
Listen, please don't be mad at me. I couldn't stand it if you were mad at me.
Man, look, I do not care if you have psychotic episodes, but for God's sake, don't whine about them.
You guys all right?
Oh, yeah, fine.
Couldn't be better, Captain. Yourself?
What happened? Well, we answered that disturbance call and found this sick human being going bananas on a subway platform.
He was trying to force people to get into single file, go into the subway. He was prodding them with the barrel of this revolver.
Well, you see, I had to. You see, people kept jumping and shoving into each other. I had to step in. Someone would have been hurt if I didn't.
Just settle down, Mr.
Nicholas Baskin. Mr. Baskin is an air traffic controller, Barney.
What? What? All that garbage you read in the papers about we're all going to flip out sooner or later? We can't handle that kind of pressure? Too much responsibility? Is that what you meant? Is that what's going on behind that smug little awe of yours?
Well?
Mr. Baskin, Sergeant Harris will take a statement.
Come on, Baskin, right here.
What was with the shooting?
Go ahead, Arthur. Tell him.
Not much to it. Gun went off. Luckily, nobody got hurt.
Oh, come on. Let's not mince words, Dietrich.
Wait a minute. What's going on here? What happened?
I'll tell you what happened. Chucko here walked up to me, stuck his gun in my face, cocked the hammer, was about to pull the trigger, and Dietrich knocked his arm away just as the gun went off and thereby saved my life.
Yeah, it was something like that.
It was exactly like that, and you know it. Excuse me.
So adrenaline's funny stuff, eh?
I wouldn't beg like this if it wasn't a life and death situation.
For the last time, stop drooling on my baseball.
You understand what I'm...
How's it going, Woj?
Okay, just a clown keeps begging all over my desk.
Got a make on him?
Yeah, it checks out. Billings, Montana.
Oh.
It's got a clean record, though. It was even in the service.
Really?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
I was in the Army.
Navy.
Oh, yeah. Boats, right?
How long were you in the Navy, Mr. Kendall?
4 years. Fellas, isn't there some way we could straighten out this little error on my part if I could perhaps apologize to this man or offer him a couple of bucks for the inconvenience?
I'm afraid not, Mr. Kendall.
I got a plane to catch back to Billings.
Tough toenails.
You miss a flight to Billings, buddy. You got a hell of a wait for the next one.
Sit. Another outburst like that, I'll handcuff your lips together. Stern, but effective.
Could you hurry it up a little bit? Because I really have to get back to work.
So soon after the breakdown?
Listen, I just got a little wound up, that's all. You know, it's one of those days. You know, I mean, imagine if you had a look at these blips all day long. Scurrying here and darting there. I mean, one of them might be a tour to Hawaii.
Mm-hmm.
And these blips are my responsibility. I have to personally guide that little green pulse of light safely through my area. Those people's vacations depend on me.
Look, how would you like to go on one?
On what? Vacation. I have 2 weeks coming up in August.
Look, why don't you let me speak to your superior? Maybe I can get that moved up a little bit.
Do you think you could?
Oh, hey, just let me try.
I would appreciate that.
Yeah. So would the tourist industry.
Sir, Mr. Cotterman's all set.
Okay, thank you, Levitt.
You're welcome, sir. I mean, considering I wasn't even prepared.
Levitt! All right, maybe at lunchtime you can run home and change.
Thank you, sir. I already thought of that, but with the lunchtime traffic, we'll see how it goes, sir.
Fine. Fine.
Captain, I'm all done.
Thank you for your cooperation. Glad we could be of help this time.
Well, thank you.
Did you sign a complaint?
Hey! I don't care about my lips. You can't go through with this.
All right, Kendall, that's enough. Sit down.
No, I got a request.
I'm putting you in the cage.
Please call this number. Just ask for Monahan. He'll explain everything.
Come on, honestly. Let's go.
Please, no, I won't go crazy again. Please. Damn it, my life is in danger.
Oh, no. You're not going to keep me up at night racked with guilt.
Hold the number.
All right, Woj, I'll try to do it.
Thank you, thank you. God bless you.
Okay, okay.
Thanks. Thank you. God bless you. Right. Sit. Stop. That's it. No more. Thank you.
Dietrich. I owe you a debt which I will never be able to repay totally. But I'm gonna try like hell.
Hey, it was nothing. Forget it.
You'd like that, wouldn't you?
Listen, it was part of the job. You would have done the same thing for me. I'm afraid I'm gonna have to insist you respond to that.
Don't you want to know the facts, Mr. Monahan? Yes, I understand. Mr. Monahan's with the Justice Department. We're not supposed to do anything with Kendall till he gets here.
And that's it?
Something about opening a whole can of worms.
Is that lunch then?
Lo?
Stop!
All right. You with a mustache? Walk on by.
Come on, go through. Come on, go through.
You can continue.
I take it you've made provisions for Mr. Baskin?
Yeah, Barn, but I figured air travel was inappropriate, so I booked him on a locomotive.
You didn't think I had another one in me, did you?
Mr. Monahan.
Oh, my God. Who's in charge here?
I'm Captain Miller.
For heaven's sake, Miller, why didn't you just stick him in a display window?
Look, I'm not too sure I understand what's going on here.
I'm Chester Monahan, counsel for the Justice Department.
Which I take it has some kind of interest in Mr. Kendall?
Interest in Kendall? Captain, we created Kendall.
Will my office do?
Yes, thank you.
Listen, what's going on?
This will just take a few minutes, Mr. Carter.
Thank God you got here, Monahan. They were out for blood.
You made a mistake coming back here. You could have been killed. I don't care about that. But you made us look bad.
He's here to help me.
Dietrich? Hey, I've got two fifth-row orchestra seats for the Philharmonic tonight. You want them? They're yours.
No, thanks. I'm busy.
Well, it'll mean calling in a lot of favors, but I think I can get you into Studio 54 this Saturday.
I was there for the opening.
Arthur, look, I've got three vacation days coming. Take them.
Harris, you don't owe me anything.
Look, I'm sorry, man, but that's just the way I feel, you know? So if there's anything, I mean anything you want, please feel free to ask.
Can I call you Ron?
No.
I knew I was pushing.
His name is not Kendall.
I didn't think he looked like a Kendall.
I didn't choose a name anyway. That's somebody else's job.
And your job, Mr. Monahan, is...
Captain, in 1975, Kendall testified against some very powerful and dangerous people. They were all convicted.
And as a witness, his life was in danger, so you gave him a new identity.
We found that keeping them alive provides an incentive to the others.
I can see where it would. There's only one problem, Mr. Monahan. Your Mr. Kendall has committed armed robbery.
So?
So, he's under arrest.
No, I'm afraid that's out of the question.
No. You don't seem to understand. This is a citizen's complaint. We have no power to drop this charge.
Then the citizen will have to be persuaded. Oh, maybe duty to country, protecting a human life, that sort of angle.
I'm afraid that sort of angle is not going to be very effective with a shopkeeper who's been robbed five times. Mr. Cotterman is quite anxious to see Mr. Kendall in prison.
And I sympathize with him. Kendall is the scum of the earth, a snitch, a low-life, petty criminal who'd turn in his grandmother if he thought it would benefit him. He should be in jail. He should be removed from human society permanently. But it's my job to protect that valueless, insignificant life.
You enjoy your work, Mr. Monahan?
Love it.
All right. Come on, Baskin, let's go.
Where are we going?
Downstairs for pictures, prints, and then to the hospital.
Hospital? No, well, listen, I'm not ailing.
They'll help you.
I'm just a little tired.
They'll let you sleep. Come on.
Afternoon.
Can't tell by you.
Beg your pardon?
Nothing. Come on.
Captain, may I ask you now what's going on?
Yes, Mr. Cotterman. This is Mr. Monahan. He's with the Justice Department. He has a few words to say to you. This is Mr. Cotterman.
How do you do, sir?
How do you do?
Mr. Cotterman, although the robbery which occurred in your establishment was unfortunate, I'm afraid that we... We, the federal government, that is, are forced to ask you to indulge us in this matter.
What matter?
Okay, Wojo.
He's right. What do you want with my indulgence?
Mr. Cotterman, Mr. Kendall here is not who he appears to be.
I'm not, I swear.
He's actually somebody else.
This is gibberish.
All federal people talk that way, Mr. Cotterman.
Well, they do.
Cotterman, what Mr. Monahan is trying to say is that Mr. Kendall here, it's not his real name. Mr. Kendall was given a new identity by the government for his protection. You see, he was a witness in a very important case, and... Well, if you were to go to jail now under the circumstances...
If I were to go to jail, I wouldn't last a week. All right. 8, 9 days tops.
So, if I don't press charges?
Then we'll give him a new identity and relocate him again.
No.
Excuse me, did he say no?
An eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. He robbed me. I want his eye, his tooth, his whole body sent to prison.
But that too.
Captain, can I go now?
No, you may not go.
No, don't. Please don't go. Stay a while.
Captain. Tell him about the duty to country, protecting a life, all that stuff. You remember.
Captain, can I please go home?
Mr. Cotterman, you can leave whenever you want.
Thanks.
Provided you understand what it is that Mr. Monahan has been trying to say to you. The fact of the matter is that if Mr. Kendall goes to jail now, the odds are, and I know of no pretty way to put this, the odds are he will be killed. You will have the satisfaction of seeing him punished for his crime. Why don't you check over your statement? Levitt, can I have the statement?
Sir.
Thank you, Levitt. Here, have a seat over here. You can just check it for accuracy, huh?
Yes.
Yes, and last Christmas, somebody gave me one of those, you know, those video ping pong games that you hook up to your TV.
Mm-hmm.
I tell you, that little ball made me crazy. I kept trying to talk it down.
Oh, well, I see. Yeah. Have a seat.
Oh.
Barney, the ambulance is downstairs for Mr. Baskin.
All right, relax. I'll have Levitt take him down. Levitt?
Sir?
You want to run Mr. Baskin down in the ambulance?
Glad to, sir.
Levitt?
Sir?
That outfit.
Well, thank you, sir. I had to improvise. I didn't have enough time to go home, so I rented this.
Rented it?
Yeah, shop around the corner, only $20. It's tax deductible as a business expense, so I figure what the hell. Yeah, besides, I'd hate to embarrass you. What if we had a surprise inspection?
What if?
Right, sir. Okay, let's go, Baskin. The ambulance is waiting.
Levitt, you... You better wear your badge on the outside.
Right. Okay, goodbye, everybody. Thank you.
Good luck, Mr. Baskin.
Happy landings.
And you too. And you will, as long as there are guys like me on the job. Oh, I don't mean like this. I know I need a little rest period now, but I want you to know that me and the guys that work with me,
We'll always take care of you people when you're up there.
And we appreciate it.
Did you realize that it's safer to fly in an airplane than it is to ride in a car?
That's true. But you don't need a ramp to get out of a car. Maybe I need a little rest myself.
Here you go. Pilot with the rest of them. You think I want to look at that face in my dreams every night? Better he should be set free.
Mr. Kahneman, the Justice Department appreciates it.
Justice? Huh! I had revenge in my heart, just like everybody else. Revenge is sweet, Captain. Very sweet. That I'm trying to cut down.
Okay, Kendall, let's go.
Oh, Mr. Monahan, I really appreciate you taking
this. You've stained my record.
I'm sorry. Maybe I couldn't help myself, and I...
You ever heard of Kansas?
What?
Thank you, Captain. We appreciate your assistance. Kendall?
Mr. Monahan, it's a little cruel.
You know what's in Kansas, Mr. Kendall?
What? Wheat. Sounded like wheat. Didn't it?
Well, gentlemen, long day.
Dietrich, I'd like to, you know, settle this little score between us once and for all.
Unless you think you're going a little too far with this, Ray.
No, I don't.
Just making him feel bad.
I'm trying to make him feel good. Look, I'm prepared to offer money.
I don't want any money.
Name your price.
$100.
$100 it is. All right. There you go.
Thanks.
Yeah, we're even.
You.
Hey, Dietrich. Mm. You will cash it. He wouldn't.
It would serve you right if he did.
Dietrich, don't you touch that handle. Dietrich! Dietrich!
This is gibberish.
All federal people talk that way, Mr. Kahneman.
Well, they do.
Kahneman, what Mr. Monahan is trying to say is that Mr. Kendall here, that's not his real name. Mr. Kendall was given a new identity by the government for his protection. You see, he was a witness in a very important case, and, well, if you were to go to jail now under the circumstances...
If I were to go to jail, I wouldn't last a week. All right. 9 days tops.
So, if I don't press charges?
Then we'll give him a new identity and relocate him again.
No.
Excuse me, did he say no?
An eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. He robbed me. I want his eye, his tooth, his whole body sent to prison. But that too.
Captain, can I go now?
No, you may not go.
No, don't. Please don't go. Stay a while.
Captain. Tell him about the duty to country, protecting a life, all that stuff. You remember.
Captain, can I please go home?
Mr. Cotterman, you can leave whenever you want.
Thanks.
Provided you understand what it is that Mr. Monahan has been trying to say to you. The fact of the matter is that if Mr. Kendall goes to jail now, the odds are, and I know of no pretty way to put this, the odds are he will be killed. You will have the satisfaction of seeing him punished for his crime. Why don't you check over your statement? Levitt, can I have the statement?
Sir.
Thank you, Levitt. Okay, have a seat over here. You can just check it for accuracy, huh?
Yes.
Yes, and last Christmas, somebody gave me one of those, you know, those video ping pong games that you hook up to your TV.
Mm-hmm.
I tell you, that little ball made me crazy. I kept trying to talk it down.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Have a seat. Oh. Barney, the ambulance is downstairs for Mr. Baskin.
All right, relax. I'll have Levitt take him down. Levitt.
Sir.
You want to run Mr. Baskin down in the ambulance?
Glad to, sir.
Levitt.
Sir.
That outfit.
Well, thank you, sir. I had to improvise. I didn't have enough time to go home, so I rented this.
Rented it?
Yeah, shop around the corner, only $20. It's tax deductible as a business expense, so I figure what the hell. Yeah, besides, I'd hate to embarrass you. What if we had a surprise inspection?
What if?
Right, sir. Okay, let's go, Baskin. The ambulance is waiting.
Levitt, you better wear your badge on the outside.
Right. Okay, goodbye, everybody. Thank you.
Good luck, Mr. Baskin.
Happy landings.
And you too. And you will, as long as there are guys like me on the job. Oh, I don't mean like this. I know I need a little rest period now, but I want you to know that me and the guys that work with me will always take care of you people when you're up there.
And we appreciate it.
Do you realize that it's safer to fly in an airplane than it is to ride in a car?
That's true. But you don't need a ramp to get out of a car. Maybe I need a little rest myself.
Here you go. Pilot with the rest of them. You think I want to look at that face in my dreams every night? Better he should be set free.
Mistake coming back here. You could have been killed. I don't care about that. But you made us look bad.
He's here to help me.
Dietrich? Hey, I've got two fifth row orchestra seats for the Philharmonic tonight. You want them? They're yours.
No, thanks. I'm busy.
Well, it'll mean calling in a lot of favors, but I think I can get you into Studio 54 this Saturday.
I was there for the opening.
Arthur, look, I've got three vacation days coming. Take them.
Harris, you don't owe me anything.
Look, I'm sorry, man, but that's just the way I feel, you know? So, if there's anything, I mean anything you want, please, feel free to ask.
Can I call you Ron?
No.
I knew I was pushing.
His name is not Kendall.
I didn't think he looked like a Kendall.
I didn't choose a name anyway. That's somebody else's job.
And your job, Mr. Monahan, is...
Captain, in 1975, Kendall testified against some very powerful and dangerous people.
They were all convicted.
And as a witness, his life was in danger, so you gave him a new identity.
We found that keeping them alive provides an incentive to the others.
I can see where it would. There's only one problem, Mr. Monahan. Your Mr. Kendall has committed armed robbery.
So?
So, he's under arrest.
No, I'm afraid that's out of the question.
No. You don't seem to understand. This is a citizen's complaint. We have no power to drop this charge.
Then the citizen will have to be persuaded.
Oh, maybe duty to country, protecting human life, that sort of angle.
I'm afraid that sort of angle is not going to be very effective with a shopkeeper who's been robbed 5 times. Mr. Cotterman is quite anxious to see Mr. Kendall in prison.
And I sympathize with him. Kendall is the scum of the earth, a snitch, a low-life, petty criminal who'd turn in his grandmother if he thought it would benefit him. He should be in jail. He should be removed from human society permanently. But it's my job to protect that valueless, insignificant life.
You enjoy your work, Mr. Monahan?
Love it.
All right. Come on, Baskin, let's go.
Well, where are we going?
Downstairs for pictures, prints, and then to the hospital.
Hospital? No, well, listen, I'm not ailing.
They'll help you.
I'm just a little tired.
They'll let you sleep. Come on.
Afternoon.
Can't tell by you.
Beg your pardon?
Nothing. Come on.
Captain, may I ask you now what's going on?
Yes, Mr. Cotterman. This is Mr. Monahan. He's with the Justice Department. He has a few words to say to you. This is Mr. Cotterman.
How do you do, sir?
How do you do?
Mr. Cotterman, although the robbery which occurred in your establishment was unfortunate, I'm afraid that we, the federal government, that is, are forced to ask you to indulge us in this matter.
What matter?
Okay, Wojo.
He's right. What do you want with my indulgence?
Mr. Cotterman, Mr. Kendall here is not who he appears to be.
I'm not, I swear.
He's actually somebody else. In here, Harpo.
Listen, please don't be mad at me. I couldn't stand it if you were mad at me.
Man, look, I do not care if you have psychotic episodes, but for God's sake, don't whine about them.
You guys all right?
Oh, yeah, fine.
Couldn't be better, Captain. Yourself?
What happened?
Well, we answered that disturbance call and found this sick human being going bananas on a subway platform.
He was trying to force people to get into single file, go into the subway. He was prodding them with the barrel of this revolver.
Well, you see, I had to. You see, people kept jumping and shoving into each other. I had to step in. Someone would have been hurt if I didn't.
Just settle down, Mr.
Nicholas Baskin. Mr. Baskin is an air traffic controller, Barney.
What? What, all that garbage you read in the papers about we're all going to flip out sooner or later? We can't handle that kind of pressure? Too much responsibility? Is that what you meant? Is that what's going on behind that smug little awe of yours?
Well?
Mr. Baskin, Sergeant Harris will take a statement.
Come on, Baskin, right here.
What was with the shooting?
Go ahead, Arthur. Tell him.
Not much to it. Gun went off. Luckily, nobody got hurt.
Oh, come on. Let's not mince words, Dietrich.
Wait a minute. What's going on here? What happened?
I'll tell you what happened. Chucko here walked up to me, stuck his gun in my face, cocked the hammer, was about to pull the trigger, and Dietrich knocked his arm away just as the gun went off and thereby saved my life.
Yeah, it was something like that.
Mm-mm. It was exactly like that, and you know it. Excuse me.
So adrenaline's funny stuff, eh?
I wouldn't beg like this if it wasn't a life and death situation.
For
for the last time, stop drooling on my baseball.
You understand what I'm...
How's it going, boys? Okay, just a clown keeps begging all over my desk.
Got a make on him?
Yeah, he checks out. Billings, Montana.
Oh.
He's got a clean record, though. He was even in the service.
Really?
Uh-huh. Yeah,
I was in the Army.
Navy.
Oh, yeah. Boats, right?
How long were you in the Navy, Mr. Kendall?
4 years. Fellas, isn't there some way we could straighten out this little error on my part if I could perhaps apologize to this man or offer him a couple of bucks for the inconvenience?
I'm afraid not, Mr. Kendall.
I got a plane to catch back to Billings.
Tough toenails.
You miss a flight to Billings, buddy. You got a hell of a wait for the next one.
Sit. Another outburst like that, I'll handcuff your lips together.
Stern, but effective.
Could you hurry it up a little bit? Because I really have to get back to work.
So soon after the breakdown?
Listen, I just got a little wound up, that's all. You know, it's one of those days. You know, I mean, imagine if you had a look at these blips all day long. Scurrying here and darting there. I mean, one of them might be a tour to Hawaii.
Mm-hmm.
And these blips are my responsibility. I have to personally guide that little green pulse of light safely through my area. Those people's vacations depend on me.
Look, how would you like to go on one?
On what? Vacation. I have 2 weeks coming up in August.
Look, why don't you let me speak to your superior? Maybe I can get...
Want to see me, sir?
Yes, Levitt. We're still a little short-handed. I'm going to have to ask you to fill in. Something the matter?
Well, it's my clothes.
Well, what about them?
They're not plain. As in...
Plain clothes. I figured that out.
I could be home and back in an hour, sir.
Levitt, there's no time for that, and it really doesn't make that much difference, sir.
I beg to differ.
There's no time for begging either, Levitt.
Yes, sir. I'll just hold those thoughts until I sense a law.
I appreciate it.
Officer, what are you getting so excited for? So I made a little mistake.
Yeah. You got caught.
Captain, how are you?
Mr. Carter, man, not... Yeah. Another robbery?
Mm. Fifth time. But with a twist. We caught one.
Congratulations.
Shut up. His name is Calvin J. Kendall. I was walking by Mr. Carterman's store, and I kind of peeked in through the window, and here's this clown holding a gun on him.
Yeah, he was waving it in my face, demanding money.
I wasn't demanding. I was just joking around.
You threatened to blow my head off.
I meant that figuratively, not literally.
What's that supposed to mean?
I don't think I have to answer that.
Yo.
Levitt?
Sir?
Mr. Carterman, Officer Levitt will take a statement.
Can't you just use the one I gave you last time?
I'm afraid not.
Ah, who cares? It'll be kind of fun this time. I get to put somebody away. Nothing personal, you understand.
Now, go ahead and enjoy yourself.
Sir, have a seat. Oh, yeah. I hope you'll forgive the way I'm dressed.
Yeah, forget it.
Thank you.
Mr. Kendall, is it possible we've met before?
Who, me? Not unless you spent some time up around Billings, Montana.
Billings, Montana? No, I've never been there.
Don't feel bad. It's kind of like Cleveland with sheep.
Well, Joe, let's run a check on Mr. Kendall here, huh?
Sure, Barney. On your feet, Kendall. Come on, come on, come on.
Sit. Fourth precinct, would you hold? Yeah, Kobe. Harrison Dietrich was shot at? Are they all right? Okay, they were checking out a disturbance. Who cares? Are they all right? They are.
Well, why didn't you say so in the first place?
Well, think a minute, Cogan. That should have been the first words out of your mouth.
What's going on? Harrison Dietrich was shot at.
Are they all right?
Yeah, they were checking out this disturbance.
Whoa, Joe!
Yeah, they're fine.
Thank you.
Cogan? Cogan? Cogan will fill you in on details as soon as he finishes laughing.
Good.
Oh, hey, just let me try.
I would appreciate that.
Yeah. So with the tourist industry.
Sir, Mr. Cotterman's all set.
Okay, thank you, Levitt.
You're welcome, sir. I mean, considering I wasn't even prepared.
Levitt! All right, maybe at lunchtime you can run home and change.
Thank you, sir. I already thought of that, but with the lunchtime traffic, we'll see how it goes, sir.
Fine. Fine.
Captain, I'm all done.
Thank you for your cooperation. Glad we could be of help this time.
Well, thank you.
Did you sign a complaint?
Hey! I don't care about my lips. You can't go through with this.
All right, Kendall, that's enough. Sit down.
No, I got a request.
I'm putting you in the cage.
Please call this number. Just ask for Monahan, he'll explain everything.
Come on, let's go.
Please, I won't go crazy again, please. Damn it, my life is in danger.
Oh, no. You're not gonna keep me up at night racked with guilt.
Hold the number.
All right, Ward, you'll try to do it.
Thank you, thank you. God bless you.
Okay, okay.
Thanks. Thank you. God bless you. Right. Sit. Stop. That's it. No more. Thank you.
Dietrich. I owe you a debt which I will never be able to repay totally. But I'm gonna try like hell.
Hey, it was nothing. Forget it.
You'd like that, wouldn't you?
Listen, it was part of the job. You would have done the same thing for me. I'm afraid I'm gonna have to insist you respond to that.
Don't you want to know the facts, Mr. Monahan? Yes, I understand.
Mr. Monahan's with the Justice Department.
We're not supposed to do anything with Kendall till he gets here.
And that's it?
Something about opening a whole can of worms.
Is that lunch, then?
Lo?
Stop!
All right. You with a mustache? Walk on by.
Come on, go through. Come on, go through.
You can continue.
Hey,
take it you've made provisions for Mr. Baskin?
Yeah, Barn, but I figured air travel was inappropriate, so I booked him on a locomotive. You didn't think I had another one in me, did you?
Mr. Monahan.
Oh, my God. Who's in charge here?
I'm Captain Miller.
For heaven's sake, Miller, why didn't you just stick him in a display window?
Look, I'm not too sure I understand what's going on here.
I'm Chester Monahan, counsel for the Justice Department.
Which I take it has some kind of interest in Mr. Kendall?
Interest in Kendall? Captain, we created Kendall.
Will my office do?
Yes, thank you.
Listen, what's going on?
This will just take a few minutes, Mr. Carter.
Thank God you got here, Monahan. They were out for blood.
You made a mistake.
Wanted to see me, sir?
Yes, Levitt. We're still a little short-handed. I'm going to have to ask you to fill in. Something the matter?
Well, it's my clothes.
Well, what about them?
They're not plain. As in...
plain clothes. I figured that out.
I could be home and back in an hour, sir.
Levitt, there's no time for that, and it really doesn't make that much difference, sir.
I beg to differ.
There's no time for begging either, Levitt.
Yes, sir. I'll just hold those thoughts until I sense a law.
I appreciate it.
Come on, here. Office. What are you getting so excited for? So I made a little mistake.
Yeah. You got caught.
Captain, how are you?
Mr. Carter, man, not... Yeah. Another robbery?
Mm. Fifth time. But with a twist. We caught one.
Congratulations.
Shut up.
His name is Calvin J. Kendall. I was walking by Mr. Carterman's store, and I kind of peeked in through the window, and here's this clown holding a gun on him.
Yeah, he was waving it in my face, demanding money.
I wasn't demanding. I was just joking around.
You threatened to blow my head off.
I meant that figuratively, not literally.
What's that supposed to mean?
I don't think I have to answer that.
No words, you're welcome.
Yo.
Levitt?
Sir?
Mr. Carterman, Officer Levitt will take a statement.
Can't you just use the one I gave you last time?
I'm afraid not.
Ah, who cares? It'll be kind of fun this time. I get to put somebody away. Nothing personal, you understand.
Now, go ahead, enjoy yourself.
Sir, have a seat. Oh, yeah. I hope you'll forgive the way I'm dressed.
Yeah, forget it.
Thank you.
Mr. Kendall. Possible we've met before.
Who, me? Not unless you spent some time up around Billings, Montana.
Billings, Montana? No, never been there.
Don't feel bad. It's kind of like Cleveland with sheep.
Well, Joe, let's run a check on Mr. Kendall here, huh?
Sure, Barn. On your feet, Kendall. Come on, come on, come on. Sit. Fourth precinct, would you hold? Yeah, Kobe. Harrison Dietrich was shot at? Are they all right? Okay, they were checking out a disturbance. Who cares? Are they all right? They are. Well, why didn't you say so in the first place? Well, think a minute, Kogan. That should have been the first words out of your mouth.
What's going on?
Harrison Dietrich was shot at.
Are they all right?
Yeah, they were checking out this disturbance.
Whoa, Joe!
Yeah, they're fine.
Thank you.
Kogan? Kogan? Kogan will fill you in on details as soon as he finishes laughing.
Thank you.
In here, Harpo.
Listen, please don't be mad at me. I couldn't stand it if you were mad at me.
Man, look, I do not care if you have psychotic episodes, but for God's sake, don't whine about them.
You guys all right?
Oh, yeah, fine.
Couldn't be better, Captain. Yourself?
What happened? Well, we answered that disturbance call and found this sick human being going bananas on a subway platform.
He was trying to force people to get into single file going through the subway. He was prodding them with the barrel of this revolver.
Well, you see, I had to. You see, people kept jumping and shoving into each other. I had to step in. Someone would have been hurt if I didn't.
Just settle down, Mr.
Nicholas Baskin. Mr. Baskin is an air traffic controller, Barney.
What? What? All that garbage you read in the papers about we're all going to flip out sooner or later? We can't handle that kind of pressure? Too much responsibility? Is that what you meant? Is that what's going on behind that smug little of yours?
Well?
Mr. Baskin, Sergeant Harris will take a statement.
Come on, Baskin, right here.
What was with the shooting?
Go ahead, Arthur. Tell him.
Not much to it. Gun went off. Luckily, nobody got hurt.
Oh, come on. Let's not mince words, Dietrich.
Wait a minute. What's going on here? What happened?
I'll tell you what happened. Chucko here walked up to me, stuck his gun in my face, cocked the hammer, was about to pull the trigger, and Dietrich knocked his arm away just as the gun went off and thereby saved my life.
Yeah, something like that.
It was exactly like that, and you know it. Excuse me.
So adrenaline's funny stuff, eh?
I wouldn't beg like this if it wasn't a life and death situation.
For the last time, stop drooling on my baseball.
You understand what I'm...
How's it going, Boj?
Okay, just a clown keeps begging all over my desk.
Got a make on him?
Yeah, it checks out. Billings, Montana.
Oh. It's got a clean record, though. It was even in the service. Really?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I was in the Army.
Navy.
Oh, yeah. Boats, right?
How long were you in the Navy, Mr. Kendall?
4 years. Fellas, isn't there some way we could straighten out this little error on my part if I could perhaps apologize to this man or offer him a couple of bucks for the inconvenience?
I'm afraid not, Mr. Kent.
I got a plane to catch back to Billings.
Tough toenails.
You miss a flight to Billings, buddy. You got a hell of a wait for the next one.
Shit. Another outburst like that, I'll handcuff your lips together.
Stern, but effective.
Could you hurry it up a little bit? Because I really have to get back to work.
So soon after the breakdown?
Listen, I just got a little wound up, that's all. You know, it's one of those days. You know, I mean, imagine if you had a look at these blips all day long. Scurrying here and darting there. I mean, one of them might be a tour to Hawaii.
Mm-hmm.
And these blips are my responsibility. I have to personally guide that little green pulse of light safely through my area. Those people's vacations depend on me.
Look, how would you like to go on one?
On what? Vacation. I have 2 weeks coming up in August.
Look, why don't you let me speak to your superior? Maybe I can get that moved up a little bit.
Do you think you could?
Oh, hey, just let me try.
I would appreciate that.
Yeah. So would the tourist industry.
Sir, Mr. Cotterman's all set.
Okay, thank you, Levitt.
You're welcome, sir. I mean, considering I wasn't even prepared.
Levitt! All right, maybe at lunchtime you can run home and change.
Thank you, sir. I already thought of that, but with the lunchtime traffic, we'll see how it goes, sir.
Fine. Fine.
Captain, I'm all done.
Thank you for your cooperation.
Glad we could be of help this time.
Well, thank you.
Did you sign a complaint?
Hey!
I don't care about my lips. You can't go through with this.
All right, Kendall, that's enough. Sit down.
No, I got a request.
I'm putting you in the cage.
Please call this number. Just ask for Monahan. He'll explain everything.
Come on, let's go.
Please, no, I won't go crazy again. Please. Damn it, my life is in danger.
Oh, no. You're not going to keep me up at night racked with guilt.
Hold the number.
All right, Woj, I'll try to do it.
Thank you. Thank you. God bless you.
Okay, okay.
Thanks. Thank you. God bless you. Right. Sit. Stop. That's it. No more. Thank you.
Dietrich. I owe you a debt which I will never be able to repay totally. But I'm gonna try like hell.
Hey, it was nothing. Forget it.
You'd like that, wouldn't you?
Listen, it was part of the job. You would have done the same thing for me. I'm afraid I'm gonna have to insist you respond to that.
Don't you want to know the facts, Mr. Monahan? Yes, I understand.
Mr. Monahan's with the Justice Department.
We're not supposed to do anything with Kendall till he gets here.
And that's it?
Something about opening a whole can of worms.
Is that lunch then?
Lo?
Stop! All right. You with a mustache? Walk on by.
Come on, go through. Come on, go through.
You can continue.
I take it you've made provisions for Mr. Baskin?
Yeah, Barn, but I figured air travel was inappropriate, so I booked him on a locomotive.
You didn't think I had another one in me, did you?
Mr. Monahan.
Oh, my God. Who's in charge here?
I'm Captain Miller.
For heaven's sake, Miller, why didn't you just stick him in a display window?
Look, I'm not too sure I understand what's going on here.
I'm Chester Monahan, counsel for the Justice Department.
Which I take it has some kind of interest in Mr. Kendall?
Interest in Kendall? Captain, we created Kendall.
Will my office do?
Yes, thank you.
Listen, what's going on?
This will just take a few minutes, Mr. Carter.
Thank God you got here, Monahan. They were out for blood.
You made a mistake coming back here. You could have been killed. I don't care about that. But you made us look bad.
He's here to help me.
Dietrich? Hey, I've got two fifth-row orchestra seats for the Philharmonic tonight. You want them? They're yours.
No, thanks. I'm busy.
Well, it'll mean calling in a lot of favors, but I think I can get you into Studio 54 this Saturday.
I was there for the opening.
Arthur, look, I've got three vacation days coming. Take them.
Harris, you don't owe me anything.
Look, I'm sorry, man, but that's just the way I feel, you know? So if there's anything, I mean anything you want, please feel free to ask.
Can I call you Ron?
No.
I knew I was pushing.
His name is not...